Come and Eat, Shan Shan Audio Web Novel Chapter 33 She Feels Big Boss and Her Will Break Up. As a slow-witted girl from outer space, Zhu Shan Shan realizes the truth in a flash. Subconsciously, she feels Big Boss and her will break up. Thus, she dares not go to his office to have meals again, dares not let the colleagues know about them dating and even dares not tell her family. That time with Dahua, if not Fang Teng took the initiative to mention it, she reckons that she would not tell Dahua. As it turns out, she actually thinks like that. Shan Shan does not sleep well for a few consecutive days. 4 days later, Grandpa Zhu is discharged from the hospital. His illness flared up rapidly, but after undergoing the appropriate treatment, the recovery is also very fast. Mrs. Zhu and the whole family are exhausted in S City and are eager to return home, so they refuse to stay even a moment longer. Shan Shan runs around to settle the discharge paperwork and books train tickets for them. After smoothly sending them away, she feels drained of energy. However, she still cannot rest as she needs to clean up the property she borrowed from Feng Yu and returns the keys. Of course, to show her gratitude, she also has to invite her and Yuan Li Shu for a meal. Before calling Feng Yu, Shan Shan suddenly thinks actually the person she should be more thankful of this time is Big Boss. But, better wait for tomorrow when she goes to work. Feng Yu is someone who has nothing much to do and is always free. Once she hears Shan Shan wants to give her a treat, she readily says, I am free today. I am going to go shopping in the afternoon to buy clothes for the baby. I will call Li Shu along. Hence, the three people meet in a certain shopping mall. After Shan Shan treats them to a meal, they go shopping together. When shopping, Miss Fang is scary as she is so energetic, and before long there are 4 to 5 large packages in her hands. Yuan Li Shu seems to be in a very good mood. But Shan Shan always feels she looks at her in a strange way, as if sneering at her. After a full 3 hours of shopping, Miss Fang seems to have bought enough, so she calls the driver to pick her up. After a while, the driver calls back and says there is a car accident blocking traffic so he cannot make it. Fang Yu is unhappy as she does not like to take a taxi. Then, she remembers Fang Teng's residence in the city is not far from here, so she calls him. Big brother, I am shopping with Shan Shan and Li Shu. The driver cannot come, so can you come to pick us up? He says he is coming soon. Fang Yu hangs up the phone and looks at the time. Since we have to wait, we might as well continue shopping. Consequently, they continue to shop in the mall. Very soon, Fang Yu finds a pair of shoes she likes in a shoe store. The store does not have her size, so the salesperson goes to the storage room on the 5th floor to get a pair. While waiting, she casually looks around at the seasonal discount items and suddenly sees something. Shan Shan, come and try this. This pair of boots will certainly look good on you. Since knowing Fang Teng is coming, Shan Shan starts to feel ill at ease. When Fang Yu asks her to try the boots, she begins to do so and forgets to look at the size. She pushes one foot hard in. Very good, cannot take off now. Shan Shan is stupefied. Then, she only remembers to look at the size. It turns out to be 2 sizes smaller. How did she manage to push her foot in? Fang Yu uses her strength to help her to pull, wipes away some sweat and says, no, I cannot take it off, so better wait for the salesperson to come back. In the end, before the salesperson comes back, Fang Teng's call arrives. Fang Yu holds her mobile phone and says, big brother, we have not finished yet. You wait in the car park first. Yuan Li Shu, who has been standing on the side and watching all this like a comedy, suddenly suggests, it seems that we will be taking quite a while. The air in the underground car park is not good, so it is better to get Big Brother Fang to come up and join us. Fang Yu thinks she is right. Shan Shan wants to open her mouth to prevent her, but Fang Yu has already said, Big Brother, why don't you come up? We are in XX shoe store on the 1st floor. At this moment, Yuan Li Shu is feeling extremely pleased in her heart. Unlike Fang Yu's ignorance, Yuan Li Shu is acutely aware there is something wrong with Zhu Shan Shan. She soon made a correct judgment that there is certainly a problem between the couple. Moreover, she also has learned from other sources, when Zhu Shan Shan's grandpa had been hospitalized recently, Fang Teng had not visited him even once. She has always looked down on Zhu Shan Shan, so she naturally feels Fang Teng thinks Zhu Shan Shan is not good enough for him. It is most probably Fang Teng cannot stand Zhu Shan Shan's family and relatives. Fang Teng most probably feels they are unbearable. If he also sees Zhu Shan Shan's pathetic figure now, he will definitely feel she is even more unpresentable. Being not able to take off the boot seems like a small thing, yet it is also embarrassing enough. If Fang Teng is already impatient with Zhu Shanshan, it will certainly deepen his sense of disgust for her. Irreparable cracks, they are an accumulation of feelings that the other person is insufferable. Thinking about all these make Yuan Li Shu very eager to see Fang Teng show up. Shanshan glances at Yuan Li Shu, does not say anything and looks down at the boot. She has always been silly, but since getting together with Fang Teng, she suddenly starts to become more aware of all things related to Fang Teng. She practically feels Yuan Li Shu seemingly acting casually but with hidden maliciousness. However, so what, their problems have never been caused by others. Soon, Fang Teng is already walking impatiently within their line of vision. Fang Yu waves at him, "Big brother, we are here." Fang Teng sees them and glances at Zhu Shanshan. He turns, walks over and slightly impatient says, "Why delayed for so long?" Fang Yu takes a quick look at Shanshan and mumbles, "Oh, we are waiting for the salesperson to go and get my shoes." Shanshan stammers, "I tried putting on a boot but end up not being able to take it off, so we are waiting for the salesperson to come back to help." Fang Teng looks at her. Shanshan bows her head, even her hair also reveals her dejected feelings. Fang Teng snorts and walks towards Zhu Shanshan. Yuan Li Shu's heart is pounding, and she opens her eyes wide to wait to see a good show. Unexpectedly, Fang Teng walks to stand in front of Zhu Shanshan. All of a sudden, he bends one of his knee and holds up Zhu Shanshan's calf with his hand. The other hand stealthily uses some strength and pulls the boot off. Yuan Li Shu is stunned. Fang Yu is also shocked and stares with her eyes wide open. "Oh my god, my big brother is actually helping Shanshan to take off her boot in a public place with so many people." "Oh no, this is not the main point. The main point is this pose looks so much like a marriage proposal, but doing it in a department store is really not romantic." Miss Feng's train of thought is already far away. Shanshan also raises her head and is startled to see his broad shoulders so closely. The well-ironed suit on his body is creased because he bent down. His warm and strong palm stays on top of her calf. She is in a daze and feels that he is going to stand up. She can't be bothered to put on her shoes, but hurriedly stretches out her hands to hug his neck. Before he stands up, she whispers, "Are you still angrier?" Fang Teng frowns and says, "Let go and put on your shoe." Shanshan really does not listen to his order and stubbornly clings onto him. Fang Teng's body is still. Then, he holds out his hands to embrace her waist and stands up. "Are you sure you want to say this to me here?" Shanshan quiets down. Fang Teng throws the car keys in his hand to Fang Yu, "Drive yourself home." Fang Yu catches the keys and says, "Oh, twice." Then, with a dreamy expression, she drags a dissatisfied Yuan Li Shu away, resulting in her forgetting about the pair of shoes she wanted to buy. Only the two of them are left in the store, and Fang Teng lowers his head to look at her. "Now, can you put your shoes back on?" Shanshan blushes. Her bare feet are still stepping on other people's shoes. She quickly releases him and holds onto his hand for support to put on her shoes. Then, the sweating salesperson finally comes back. He sees only a man and woman are left in the store and sullenly asks, "The lady who wanted the shoes has left." Shanshan pulls Fang Teng's sleeve, "The shoes are you wanted." After paying with his credit card, Fang Teng carries the plastic bag and walks in front. Shanshan follows closely and cannot help but asks, "Where are we going?" Fang Teng does not answer. Shanshan can only silently follow behind. After walking for a while, unexpectedly someone pulls her hand into a deserted corner. "Okay, now you can say what you want to say," Fang Teng neutrally says. The corner is very quiet and cannot hear the noises in the shopping mall. After a while, Shanshan softly says, "Thank you for helping me just now. You only have this to say." Seeing that he seems to look impatient, Shanshan quickly says, "No, I want to say I'm sorry." Fang Teng has no reaction. Shanshan continues to say, "I have never thought I will break up with you. However, I also have never thought about the future. I dare not think too much. I also dare not tell my family and refuse to let my colleagues know because in my heart I feel that we may not be together for long. The gap between you and I is just too big, so I do not have confidence. I'm afraid to hear someone says, you see, they are so not matching. Hence, I hadn't refused to listen. It seems like you have done a lot in these 2 days." Fang Teng gazes at her and almost coldly says, "So, what are you going to do?" "Zhu Shanshan, the gap between us will always exist. Shan glances at him, suddenly she looks firm, makes a fist and says, so I intend, this time I must pass the CPA exam. Fang Teng stares at her and suspects he may have a hearing problem. He slowly repeats that three English letters, CPA. Yes, it is certified practicing accountant. Shan nods her head, before when I said I was taking this test, I was actually not serious, but this time it is for real. In the future, I even want to take the International Registered Accountant exam. Very well. Fang Teng touches his forehead. Zhu Shan, please explain to me how our topic is related to your career planning. No, cannot. Shan stammers in her explanation, my thoughts are like this. My personality is not any worse than you, so I do not need to work hard on this. Although there is quite a wide gap between our appearance and family background, this is natural, so I cannot do anything. Plastic surgery and reincarnation are just too difficult. Thus, I can only work hard in my career. After I finish my CPA exam, I will be a registered accountant. In any case, I have a license to practice. I certainly cannot become the best person, but I can become the best of me. I certainly cannot become the person who is your best match, but I want to use the best of me to match with you. Fang Teng looks at Zhu Shan's serious look in her eyes. Actually, he is still a bit angry, but instantly his heart softens and is in a total mess. He remembers his sister asked him before why he likes Zhu Shan. Perhaps, initially he had not been that fond of her. He merely feels she is amusing, cute, has white and soft skin which he feels tempted to pinch, and he feels very relaxed when seeing her. He has seen too many beautiful flowers. They are well-educated and well-bred young ladies from prestigious families, yet he has not really felt tempted by them. Finding such a worry-free and well-behaved person is also pretty good. He believes all along he is maintaining a can-leave-anytime stance and even adopts a detached point of view, watching her overcautious and indecisive behavior. However, at this moment, he discovers that he does not want to move back a step but wants to just step forward to embrace her. Thus in the next second, Shan is pulled into a strong embrace. Shan is stunned for a moment, then carefully holds out her hands and hugs him back. Actually, I have made another decision. After a while, Shan says in his embrace. I will tell you tomorrow. The next day at noon, it is time for lunch and a colleague asks Shan, let's go to the cafeteria. Shan shakes her head, you go, I am going somewhere else to eat. Where are? Actually, the colleague is just asking casually. Fang Teng's office. Shan frankly replies, colleague. Under the colleague's shocked and or curious gazes, Shan holds her lunchbox and goes to the 22nd floor. Linda and the others are still working and Shan steps forward to ask, Linda, is the president in his office? Linda hesitates since Zhu Shan has not come up for a long time, so can she let her go in now? Senior assistant Fang just happens to come and sees Zhu Shan, so out of concern asks about Grandpa Zhu's current health condition. Seeing senior assistant Fang, who is very close to the president, being so familiar with Shan, Linda understands everything now. On one hand, she secretly hates senior assistant Fang for not passing on the information. On the other hand, she eagerly says, he is inside. Do you want me to inform him? Shan politely declines, I will go in and look for him myself. Shan stands outside the president's office and knocks on the door, something which she has not done for a long time. Come in. Fang Teng, who is working hard, says in a deep and low voice. Shan pushes open the door, but does not go in. Instead, she is holding her lunchbox and standing in the doorway and asking, can I come here to eat my lunch? Fang Teng, who has his eyes fixated on his documents, is surprised and raises his eyes. He sees her, smiles happily and puts down the pen in his hand, welcome.